Hello friends, welcome to my channel Sushant Chess. Today we are at the next topic, that is the endgame studies explained. We are at the 87th position of our topic. We have got a very interesting position here. It is white to play and win. One of the main aspects of this endgame is the rook versus knight scenario here, which we can get in many positions where we know that the rook cannot win against the knight, especially if the knight remains near the pawn king. So let's get started with the position and let's look at some candidate moves. Firstly, we can see that if king can take the pawn on e7, drawing the game will be easy in many cases. So let's get down with two candidate moves here. One is rook g8, stopping the pawn from queening, but we see that the e7 pawn can be taken in that. And there is the second move, kd5, where also we see that the e7 pawn can be taken. And at the same time, we see that the g1 pawn is queening with a check. First, if we try to move the king away from this check, then here simply black can take ke7, when the big problem is that the knight is coming to f6 with a check. So rook g8 won't do anymore, and after rook c7 check, king simply goes to f6, not e8, where kd6 would be winning for white. Again, after e7, g1 queen, there is no direct way for white to win. White can try rook f7 check, and here as well, after the move kg6, we see that the rook is struggling to stop the pawn from queening. So, and here even e7 would lose after kf7. Thus, the only way would be rook c1 here, when we see that after nf4 check, e6 would be taken and the game will be easily drawn. Let's look at the main move now. White has to play the move rook g8. Let's look at some ideas. Firstly, if king takes e7, now the problem is that if rook takes g2, then there is nf4 check when the game is instantly drawn. But here comes the very strong ke5, when the knight checks are avoided and we see that this knight is stuck. Okay, and after the move knight f6, there is just rook g7 check when f6 knight will be taken. Rook still controls the queening square. So this is a very important zugzwang situation where black finds himself. After g1, there is just rook g1. So the main line happens to be the move ng7, when the rook's path is blocked and now the pawn is about to queen with a check. Thus we see that e8 queen here is a big blunder, because knight still attacks the queen. First g-pawn would queen with a check, then after any king move, just the queen moves away with a check and knight takes the queen, and black wins in this case as well. Rook into g7, king takes g7, and then e8 also draws very easily. After e8 queen, g1 equal to queen check, and we see that after any move, right from c4, e4, c3, wherever, the queen starts giving check from c1, and these checks are unstoppable. So this will also result in a draw. But the solution is not really very complicated if we spot the move kd5. Firstly, white stops the pawn from queening with a check, and secondly, if g1 queens, then there is the very interesting e8 knight check, and we see that all moves lose very comfortably, because after ke7 there is just rook g7, queen g7, knight g7, white is winning. King g6 just allows rook g7 and the queen is lost. Thus the only move king f5, knight takes the knight with a check, and wherever the king moves, be it f6, f4, g6, g5 or g4, wherever, there is the knight check on h5 and the black queen is lost. So perhaps the only attempt is the move knight e8, when after rook e8, black wants to queen the pawn, but here too, just rook takes g2, king takes e7, and we get a similar situation as before, the move ke5, very simple and effective. Now the black king has to go to either d8 or f8. The knight doesn't have any good place, because knight c7 just allows rook check from g7. King goes d8 and rook c7 wins very easily. King c7, then kf6 is winning king and pawn endgame. So here after king d8 or f8, both rook check, ke7, rook f7 check, king f6, rook f7 check, kg8, and rook just retreats back to f1 or f2, and we see that this pawn on e5 cannot be stopped anymore. King is cut off, and simply e7, ke6, kd7, and white queens. I hope you are finding these lessons useful. Thanks for your time.